Jordy here for Cinecom.net and welcome to Creative Tuesday. I'm currently on vacation with the family in the Netherlands, Zealand, but that doesn't stop us from creating a new video, so let's swing into it.
I was actually hoping to make a nice video here, but with the rain, I'm preferring to stay in sight. So let's do some post-production work and, in more particular, color grading. The first color grading tip: if your shots look pretty dull, you could add a fake sunlight to it. And here's a quick way to do that. Simply create a new color mat and pick an orange color. Then drag this above your clip in Premiere Pro and head over to the opacity property and change its blend mode to linear dodge add. Next, click on the pen tool and draw a mask in the corner of your clip. Now simply feather it a bunch and it seems now like you got a nice sun flare coming from the side. And if it's too hard, you can decrease the opacity or even animate it so that the sun flare flickers a bit as you move the camera around. And if you're still missing some contrast in your dull shots, well then here's a second tip to bring them more to life. The lighting on Kim is pretty flat because of the bad weather, so here's a way to add a bit more contrast over her face. With your clip selected, head over to the effects controls and take the pen tool under the Lumetri effect. Drag a mask on one side of your subject's face. Then hit the play button under the mask pads to make it follow your subject. Finally, you want to head over to the Lumetri panel and increase the highlights a little bit. Now, to make sure that the effect isn't visible, play with the feather of the mask. And you'll now notice that Kim's face will now have a brighter side, which adds more depth to the subject. The next tip is a great and simple way to add that film look to your digital video. What's typical about film is its grain. So what I'll do is just download a film grain stock. You can find them anywhere online, for example at VideoBlocks, we're also sponsoring today's episode. It's a huge library where you can download stock footage, templates, video effects, and so much more. You can find out more and start your own 7-day trial by clicking the first link in the description below. So I'm grabbing this film grain stock right here from their library. Place that film grain stock on top of your edit and change its blending mode to overlay. And now you can fine-tune the blending more by decreasing the opacity. And what I love to do next is make sure that I preserve the highlights by decreasing that slider. And you can even go a little bit further than you would normally do. Same goes for the shadows, but for here I can use the faded film controller. And that gives your digital video that film look with just only a few clicks. Now talking about film, this brings us to the next color grading hack. If you like to recreate the look from your favorite film, you can do so now quite easily. Simply load your desired film or a screen grab from it in Premiere Pro. Then with your clip selected, head over to the color wheels and match. Click on comparison view to locate the clip that you want to match the colors to, and then just simply hit match. The results will probably be not spot on, but it will already push you in the right direction, making it easier for you to continue match your clips manually. And this brings us to the last color grading tip. If you have a bunch of clips that needs to have the same basic correction, then you could add that particular correction on the source clip. Just double click on any clip in your projects panel and head over to Lumetri. Do your color correction in here and then navigate to the effects controls. Copy the Lumetri color effect, select all your clips in the projects panel and hit Ctrl or Command V to paste that effect. And now you can start editing with a basic correction. And while you're editing in your timeline, you can always switch back to the source grading by clicking on the master on top of the Lumetri panel. And this means that you're selecting the source or master clip. So this was the second time that we've made a list of 5 color grading hacks. If you would like to see the first video that we made, then make sure to click in the card up there or find a link in the description somewhere below. Thank you all so much for watching, and like always, stay creative.
So normally Jannik has a cola ban in the office, which means he can't drink cola. But since Jordy is on vacation, things are getting pretty out of hand.